In today's video, I'm going to talk about the role of the adult in a Montessori home and how it really is about a Montessori mindset. A mindset where there is respect between the parent and the child. This approach to parenting is a wonderful way to foster your child's independence, creativity, and concentration. I'm also going to talk about the importance of everyday tasks and how involving your child will benefit them for life. You'll learn some simple and free strategies to bring Montessori into your home today. So let's get started. Montessori classrooms are designed to look like home. In fact, the very first Montessori school is called Casa de Bambini, which means children's house. So your home is the exact right place for your child to learn. It begins with you. Included in the Montessori mindset is trust. A trust between parent and child. The parent trusts that the child is capable of learning and growing, and the child trusts that the parent will love them, take care of their needs, and guide them as they learn about the world. There is respect in a Montessori home. Celebrate what they can do, and don't worry too much about what they can't, because they will learn. Development unfolds naturally for every child. Your child will grow at a pace that is right for them. Once they show an interest, start including them in these everyday tasks. Parents often describe this as a time where the child really wants to help. In the kitchen, with the laundry, they just want to help everywhere that they can. Once you start including your child, these tasks may take a little bit longer, but your child is learning so much by participating in them. Not only are they developing fine motor skills, gross motor skills, you're enriching their vocabulary, there's so much learning happening. But they're also learning independence. They're learning how to be. They're learning how a household runs. One of my favorite things to hear in the classroom was, "I did it." Those three little words mean so much to a toddler when they've accomplished something for themselves. Now, every day there was at least one toddler who went home with their shoes on the wrong feet or their hat falling off of their head. But the important part was that they had done it themselves. And not to worry, they will eventually learn to put their shoes on the correct feet and to pull that hat down. Now, if you're interested in learning more about practical life exercises, if you sign up for our program, our Montessori at Home program, we will give you a monthly practical life guide where we've basically listed all of the age-appropriate activities that you can start to introduce into your home. Communicate. The best thing that you can do, and one of the easiest things you can do, you're probably already doing it, is communicate with your child. Talk to them about what you're doing, where you're going, teach them about the world. And when you're talking to them, get down on their level, eye level, so that they can see the way that your face moves, the way that your mouth moves, in order to communicate. Communication not only is going to teach them really important language skills, but it also helps them to feel safe. When we're in the loop and we know what's going on, it helps us to feel safe. And when we feel safe, we thrive. So communication is really important. And in infancy, that communication might be nonverbal. So you're down on their level, you're talking to them, and they react with a smile or reaching out to you. That's a way of communicating. And a toddler, they might need a little bit of time to process what it is that you've said and to come up with an answer. So take it really slow. Use simple language, but communicate. Tell them about the world. Make time for play. There's a common misconception in Montessori that we don't play in Montessori classrooms. And this couldn't be further from the truth. In fact, Dr. Montessori herself said, "Play is the work of the child." So in Montessori classrooms, the children are playing, but we call it work. And they are playing with toys, but we call them materials, because in a classroom, they are learning materials. So let's take a look at these shelves back here. So this is something that you might have at home, a basket full of animals. It's also something that would be found in a Montessori classroom. It would be found in the language area. Now at home, your child is playing with them creatively. You're maybe singing songs about them, imitating the sounds of the animals. And at school, I have learned as a Montessori teacher how to present these materials to the children using either a 2 or 3 period lesson in order to enrich their vocabulary. Now in my classroom, I also made time for the children to explore the work, similar to how they would be playing with them at home. Because when a child is exploring, manipulating, experimenting with materials or toys, they are learning so much. So in a Montessori home, you can absolutely have toys, but we're going to talk about how to set up a Montessori playroom in a future video. So what is the role of the adult while the child is playing? The role of the adult is to prepare the environment, so set up the shelves with toys that you think your child will be interested in. And when they're engaged in an activity, you want to step back and observe. If they're engaged, if all of their needs are met, it's okay to just step back and watch them for a little while. In fact, a teaching strategy that I learned, which is a little bit silly, but it really works, is to actually sit on your hands. When your child is engaged in an activity and they are playing independently, sit on your hands. This helps you from refraining from reaching out and interfering in what they're doing. If they don't need help, if they seem content, you really just want to sit back and observe. This is how we are going to encourage independent play. So this can begin as early as infancy. If your child is lying on their back and enjoying a mobile and doesn't seem to need your attention in that moment, just sit back and observe them. If your child is playing with toy cars and doesn't seem to need your attention at that moment, sit back and observe. You don't need to leave the room, just give them a little bit of time and space to be able to play and explore independently. You'll learn so much about your child just by spending a few minutes a day observing how they're interacting and engaging with the world around them. A motto in Montessori is to follow the child. Your child will show you what they're interested in. As I said in the beginning, you are your child's greatest teacher. Speaking from experience, part of being a great teacher is learning from your students. Montessori at home is about respecting the child, respecting that they will develop in their own unique way at a pace that is right for them. We treat the child with respect, and they in turn learn to treat others the same. If you're interested in learning how to bring Montessori into your home, sign up for our Montessori at Home program and join our growing community of Montessori families. Find the link below. Thanks so much for being here today. Please like and subscribe and look forward to more videos soon. Bye!